bones containing more minerals are denser, stronger, and less likely to break. Bone density or bone mineral density, sometimes bone mass is used, of a person can be measured via a DEXA scan, which is medical imaging using very low levels of x-rays and is a useful and inexpensive test. It is typically used to diagnose osteoporosis, but can also just be used to measure your bone density at any age. For example, if you have a genetic predisposition for osteoporosis, or if you take glucocorticoids, you may want to know what your baseline bone density is. This is the bone mass profile chart of a person over their lifetime, which tracks growing bones as well as density, showing you the dynamic and ever-changing mineral status of your bones. At birth, it starts off at its lowest and then increases as you and your bones grow. And after a certain age, you stop growing. Your bone density will continue to increase up until it reaches a maximum density, typically around the age of 30. And this is a critical point called the peak bone mass or peak bone density, because from this point onwards, your bone density will not increase any further. And for the next few years, which may last 15 to 20 years for women, depending on when they get menopause, most references will indicate there is a slight decrease in bone mass during this time, although this period could also be viewed as a period of steady state. And during this time, the bones are not growing, but are being continuously remodeled. So here the chart is showing the modeling phase, which is the bone growing phase at the first part of life versus the remodeling phase. The sex hormones are crucial for bone health and density. So when menopause transition or perimenopause occurs, the sudden drop in estrogen causes an accelerated drop in bone mineral density, which then levels out after the transition is complete, giving this distinctive slope here, and then continues to drop, but at a slower rate as you continue to get older. And then this shaded portion indicates at what bone density is considered to be osteoporosis and osteopenia, which is low bone mass, but not as extreme as osteoporosis. So you can see now why women are more likely to have osteoporosis than men, the main culprit being the drop caused by menopause, but also women have lower peak bone densities as well. So if any of you are interested in tracking what your BMD curve looks like, ideally, you'd want to get a DEXA scan around 30 years old so you have an idea of what your peak bone mineral density is, although in practice this is hardly ever done as you would need to pay for this to be done privately. And then again, when you just start perimenopause, and then again after menopause has completed, and then continue getting DEXA scans approximately every 2 to 3 years thereafter, just to get an idea of what your curve looks like. Of course, you can also get a separate recommendation from your own physician. So in practice, women only start getting scanned when they are in their 60s, because these will be provided by the government. But it would make sense to get scans done earlier, because if you find out that your bone density is on the low side earlier, then you can start working on it earlier rather than waiting until you're much older and less mobile. So whilst osteoporosis has a genetic component, you can improve your bone health and bone density. So if you are young enough, you can even start to work on increasing your peak bone mass. So having a good balanced diet and vitamin D is important, but weight-bearing physical activity is vital for increasing bone density. Modern lifestyles of poor diets and sedentary lifestyles could well be contributing factors towards the current osteoporosis epidemic. For diet, aim for a balanced diet with vegetables, proteins, and carbs, but not specifically just calcium. You also need carbs for energy in order to exercise. And in addition, a low BMI is associated with low bone density. And this is why men tend to achieve higher peak bone density, because of their bigger body and muscle mass generally, which is attributed to testosterone's anabolic properties. Other factors which are associated with reduced bone density are smoking and alcohol, and dietary factors include high salt consumption, possibly regular soda, and caffeine consumption, although there is conflicting information on things we eat which may impact bone health. But it's safe to say that a healthy, low salt diet is the best way to go for bone health. Stress and inflammation have also been associated with reducing bone density, and stress is associated with increased levels of cortisol. And then after the peak bone density phase, these bone healthy practices can help you reduce the steepness of the decline in bone mass. So for example, giving yourself this curve instead of this curve. It is kind of beyond the scope of this video to go into what types of exercise is best for bone health, and different people have different exercise capacities. I'll just touch on a few basics. So there are two forms of exercise which are important for bone health and helping patients with osteoporosis: weight-bearing exercise and strength training, and doing both is recommended. So weight-bearing is anything where you are moving around on your feet against gravity to apply some vibrational stress to your bone. These can be divided into low impact and high impact. And high impact exercise increases bone density more than low impact exercise. Walking, although is low impact, is a very important weight bearing exercise which is accessible to most people. And then you should also bear in mind that walking and running will not apply stress to the arms, such as the wrist, which is a common fracture site. So you need to cover this with upper body like resistance training, such as weightlifting, traditional push-ups or push-ups against a wall, or using resistance bands. Weight-bearing exercises should be performed 30 minutes a day for 4 or more days a week. Muscle strengthening exercises at least twice a week. And it's recommended to consult with a physiotherapist or a training instructor to tailor some exercises which are suitable for you. And there are some forms of exercise which are not weight-bearing and so won't help with bone density. So these include cycling and swimming. If bone health is important to you, you should incorporate additional weight-bearing exercise into your routine if you are an avid cyclist or swimmer.